Hello YouTube, Chambasi Vate here. Today I'm gonna show you, actually I'm gonna continue from the previous tutorial, but this time we're gonna go for the advanced method of searching through for files in a specified pack and then listing those files in a list box or something. But this time we're gonna be using the advanced method that is mostly used by those companies that they develop antiviruses and files related applications. Okay, so let's just jump to it. When I say list files like that, so but now we're gonna add a list box. Yes, we're gonna add a list box. I am tired now, sorry to say. Okay, I'm gonna add a list box, and then there's this data type called tsearchrec. I'm not sure if you want to set up on it. There we go, tsearchrec. It used to contain information or records about a certain file, so you can, I'm gonna name it rec like this. And then if you can check each and every file, it has attributes. If you can check, you can see attributes. This one is, it's a normal file, it's not hidden, it's not read only, for example. So same applies to folders, it has attributes. You can see them, you can see attributes regardless if it's a folder or not. So actually it seems like each and everything has attributes here. I am not sure, but there you can see attributes. So why am I showing you this? Okay, well, this method we're gonna use now for searching for a certain file or for searching for files in a specified directory, we will need something called attributes. These attributes, I'm gonna call it attributes like this. So actually let me verify this thing. It seems like this is a WT. Yes, WT. Yes, WT. I can tell, man, it's not good. Not, I don't know why I can't I type today. There we go, attributes. Okay, by the way, never mind the spelling. A variable, you can name it anything. I'm not that good in spellings. Okay, so attributes, you have to specify now in this way of searching for files in a specified path. You have to specify if you want a hidden file, an archive, any file, only directory, or you just have to tell the system what do you want to search for. Okay, I mean, what type of attributes you are looking for. For example, the FA, whereby F means file, A means attributes. Okay, file attributes, any file like this. Okay, file attributes, control space. You can see there is any file, there is archive. If you can go back, you can see that the moment I type FA and space by sending me FA any file, FA compressed, FA directory, in case you are looking for only directories, you're gonna go for this one, okay? Or if you are looking for encrypted files, you're gonna go for encrypted. There, if you are only looking for hidden files, you're gonna go for hidden, okay? But if you are looking for everything, regardless if it's hidden or not hidden, it's a directory or not, we're gonna go for any file. Any file gonna bring you, including directories, hidden files, compressed files, everything. Just gonna go for FA, any file. But remember, if you are only looking for directories, make sure you only take that attribute that says FA directories. Okay. Okay, let's continue. So now that we know that we're only looking for, well, actually we are looking for any files including directories and regardless if it's hidden or not, we're gonna create a string. This string, I'm gonna call it path. Now this path is where you specify what do you want to search, where do you want to search, I mean, so, and what type do you want to search. For example, if I'm looking for a file of any named file of any extension, I'm gonna do it like this. But if I'm looking for a file that is named Temba, like this, or is named Tivate, but you don't care about the extension, you're gonna call like this, okay? But if you are looking for a file, any file of any extension, if you are looking for any file of exe files, you're gonna call like this, just like that, okay? For example, if you're looking for any text file, you're gonna go like this. In this case, let's just go for any file of any file extension, okay? Insert, okay, there we go. So now we did specify that we have a drive, which is drive D, a path is drive D. On drive D, we're looking for any file of any extension. So this thing, it doesn't care even if it's a folder or not, it will bring it for you, okay? So this FA any file here, it will simply mean if that file is hidden, the attributes of that file, as long as it matches these attributes and is matching this extension and this file name here that we're gonna specify, in my case is nothing, meaning no file name, no file extension, okay? So meaning the file will be listed. So the most important thing now is to find the first file. You have to check if you were able to get the first record. That's the most important step when you are using this method. You're gonna check using find next, control space, find next. You can see this find next there. I'm not gonna tell you all this thing, I don't know some of them, so to be honest, okay. Find first. I can't even type today, what's happening, I don't know. Okay, find first, there we go, find first. Okay, from find first, receive three parameters. The first one is the path, the second one is the attribute, and that one is, if you can see, once you see an end operator, meaning whatever this variable you want to pass there underneath this third parameter, it will be passed by reference, meaning it will be the one containing the result. Okay, so we're going to put path there like this, a path there, and then we're going to put the attribute. So I'm gonna do the magic of copy and paste, and then after that I'm gonna say store my results in this rec variable. So this thing here, oh, extra parenthesis, this thing here, if it was able to find the first record, okay, on drive D, it's gonna return a zero. Why, I don't know, but I know it returns a zero. But if it did not find any first file there, it will return not zero, okay? But if it find the first file, it's gonna return a zero. So if it found it, we wanna do something with it. In this case, maybe we wanna say show message and display the file. But hey, let me show you what you can do. You want to look through, as long as there's a file existing there on that directory, right? Which is the first thing, which is the nice thing, I mean. So it's gonna say while it was able to find the next file. If you can press control space now, it's not gonna predict unless otherwise. As you can see, it's not predicting for you. Do you see that? That thing is busy spinning. It has not produced like any pop up showing you the method named find. Or maybe it's because it's not a D, there is an E by mistake. I'm gonna put a D, find control space now, and see. Yes, you see, it's not predicting, but I know there's a method called find next, like this. And then, if the moment I open parentheses, you're gonna see it receive T search rec and by reference. So, we're gonna put that. Do you understand? So, now this find next, it's gonna return zero also, only if it was found, it found the next record. But now we haven't done anything yet with the first record we found there. So let's display the first record that we found there. For example, go like this, I'm gonna go for rec.name. There we go. In case you want to know all the variables that are underneath the structure of rec, there they are. Do you see them? Yes, you do. You can get the attributes, you can get the size, you can get the timestamp, you can of a certain file, you can get the file name. I'm gonna display the file name, that's what I'm interested in now. So I'm gonna save the whole project on my desktop. I'm gonna name it search files search files. So I'm gonna save, and then I'm gonna run it. So you can see there's a folder named this. It's not a file, by the way, that thing is a folder. I know it. So on drive D, there we go. You cannot see it, it's hidden. It's because that's FAN file. That's what we just specified here. FAN file. It will bring back even hidden files, okay? Even this one, we cannot see it. But now you can see command.txt is this file here on drive D. Let me shift a bit. Okay, components is this folder here. Debug, just like that. You can see that it's gonna list folders and files, okay? But only on drive D. Okay, so let's put them on a list box. Okay, I'm gonna go like list box one items dot add. I'm sorry to say, but I have to put rec dot name. Bam. So strange, huh? Do you see something strange? Of course there have to be something strange. If you can check, you can see there's a file named command.txt, but you do not know if it's stored in drive D or drive C, or you don't know where is this file stored, because it's not showing. Yep, it's not showing. So you cannot find out where is this thing. Like, you have to know the path of this thing, the base part of the command.txt, or any, for you to perform like delete, open, do all those things, modify this file or this directory or this folder that you are seeing there on the list box now. You just have to know where is it stored. Yeah, you have to. So let me show you how you're gonna do that, because you know that rec.name, I'm sorry to erase, rec.name will only give you the name, but it is not rec.path. Do you see rec.path? No. You see? There's not a path. There's name, attribute, size, and time. You cannot see. Oh, by the way, there's also timestamp there. You cannot see the actual path. So, for you to display also the actual path, we're gonna go with this new method that I'm gonna do now. Instead of putting this thing here, I'm gonna put like this. I'm gonna put a plus, I'm gonna do like this, I'm gonna do like this, and then I'm gonna put this part here, and I'm gonna also put it here. Yes, you guessed it, it's gonna work. You see now, there's a D, eh? You can see now, at least you know, you have an idea. That's okay, on drive D, there's a file named command.txt. Yes. Do you see that? So, but now, we are not able to list the files inside each folder. Will we? No. Okay, let's do that now. Okay, we're gonna do that right now. We're gonna create a method that's gonna do that for us. Okay, void search. Now, I don't know why do I like to name it search now, but okay, hey, it's gonna receive a string, which is a pathway in which you want to search. Yes, the path in which you want to search. Okay, so okay, how long is this video? 14 minutes. Oh my god, I'm delaying, I'm talking a lot, and I'm doing a little, which is not good. Okay, there we go. Now we have a path there, we have a string there. And then we're gonna take all this garbage and put it here. But now we're gonna erase this guy here, because now we're gonna pass the path there. Okay, so we're gonna erase this guy here. When I take this part here, we're gonna put it here. Okay, and we're gonna put it here. So, but now when you click that button, that's when you wanna begin to search. So I'm gonna pass now the D here. In case you are wondering, it's gonna do the same thing for now, but hey, this one is more advanced. Okay, it's nice to do it this way, because now you can reuse this method, call it any way you want, and just change this guy here. Okay, There we go. Oh, yes, you don't see changes. There won't be changes yet. Yes. Okay, but now you can notice that if I can click the button and click it again, it keep on adding. It does not erase. It's very simple. It's because I didn't erase. Okay, we have to erase on click of this button first before we add the files. Yes, dot clear. You guessed it. It's correct. Dot clear. Okay, and then, in case you're wondering, now really it is doing exactly what I want. So now let's get to know how to loop through everything. So it's easy. You're gonna say, I'm gonna comment now this. Oh, control. I'm gonna comment this. Yes, you're gonna say if. First, you want to know if it's an attribute or not. If rec dot attribute, I put an end there. If a directory like this, you know what does this say? Let me explain it because it is more confusing. Okay. It means the file that you are currently looking at, for example, the first file that we found. If it is not a directory, this thing gonna return a zero. That's what it means. It means if it is not a directory. Remember, you're not gonna do like this. Let me comment and show you how do you think this thing is gonna be like. I think you're gonna think, well, why can't it do like this? If this thing is not equal to this. And then no, it doesn't work like this. It doesn't work like that. It's not gonna work. Actually, I haven't tried it. Maybe we can put it into trial now. I'm gonna comment this like this. I'm gonna comment this like this. And then I'm gonna put this thing and say if it's not a directory, you're gonna do like this. If it's not a directory, meaning it's a file, right? So we're gonna put that file there. Let's try it and see if it works. And say I haven't tried this before and it's not gonna work. Bam. You see that music is a folder. Command is a file. So you can see that it's not working, right? Music is a folder. We can go to drive D now. Here, let me close this one because there are two here. You can see music, it's a directory, and then command, it's a text file. So it is not working. So yes, I was right. You cannot do it like this. Yes, you cannot do it like this. But however, you can do it like this. So this thing, it means if the current file that we found, it has the attribute that is not FA directory, it's going to return a zero. If it's not FA directory, it's going to return a zero. If it's a directory, it's going to return more than a zero. If it returns more than a zero, therefore it's a directory. If it returns exactly zero, it is not a directory. Based on what we are checking, for example, if we put FA archive, if it's not an archive, it's going to return a zero. If it's an archive, it's going to return more than a zero. Same applies FA directory. If it's not a directory, it's going to return a zero, but if it's a directory, it's going to return a zero. Let's run the program so that you can understand. There we go. You see this? These are just files. It's because, yes, they are not a directory. That thing is say, if it's not a directory, it's going to return a zero, and if it's zero, meaning it's not a directory. Therefore, it was able to list only files. Do you understand that? This qubit is not a folder, it's a file. Command is a file. This is a file. All these are files. Are these four files here? The first one is probably hidden. I cannot see it. Unless, let's come here and check. Show empty drive. Show and protected. Show. There we go. Here, it's a system file. You see, system file is there. It is hidden. And yes, you can see it is there. It's just a file, it's not a folder. So now with that, we know that the moment we put else, meaning now it's a folder, right? Now we know how to check if it's a file. So under else, here else, meaning it's a folder. Therefore, what do you want to do if it's a folder? You want to search even inside that folder. Yes, you don't want to list it, but you want to search inside that folder. But first, let me show you how you want to do it. If you were to list now, ne? It's a folder, this thing. It's listing everything, now you understand. Good. So, if it's a folder, you can also put. But, okay, what you want to do now is to search inside, right? So, we're going to call the very same method here. Only if it's a folder, like this. Okay, but now we know the path we passed this guy here will come here, okay, and then after that we're gonna put a plus, né? And then after that we're gonna put this thing here, okay. After that, we're gonna put this thing here, and then we're gonna put this dish like that. So, what does this mean? It means before it was like this. Before, when we passed it here, it was like this. Before, it was like this. And now, we found a folder named music. For example, it's the one we found here. We're going to go like music. And then, after music, we're going to put it like this. You see this two now that I added after music is this two here. I hope you understand. So, once it become like this, it called the very same method, which is called the recursive search. I'm calling a method inside itself, okay. I'm calling the very same method inside itself, okay. So yes, it become like that. So let's run the program. Oh, by the way, you obviously gonna hang, of course. You still need application dot process message, like this. Dot process, so that it does not hang. Otherwise, it's not gonna respond until it's done searching through. For example, if I remove it and run the program, see that is hanging. Yes, need to understand that is hanging. I bring back this thing. You see? Wow, that is nice. You are wondering why? What's happening now? ?. No, relax. Don't worry yet. So the thing is, there are folders that you cannot see. Like for example, there's always on Windows. There's always on Windows file system, there's always a folder called dot, named dot, and there's another folder named .. Yes, you cannot see them with your naked eyes, but the code can see them, and you do not want to search those two folders, because inside they just contains another folder dot and another folder .. So what will you do with those folders? Nothing. Okay, so you want to search proper folders, not those .. Okay. So here you can say, before you search, already you know, once you are inside the else, you know that now you is where you get the folders. But now before you search, you're gonna check if, okay, if this folder, if, remember that this guy, rec.name, gonna return both the folder name and the file name, of course. So I'm gonna check now if it is not a single dot, or it is not. The one with .. like this. Then that's when we wanna search. Try and see if it works. If it doesn't work, it's gonna tell us why. As you can see, meaning it needs an end. Bam! There we go. And trust me, it's fast. It's very, very fast compared to the first method we used. As you can see how this thing is moving. It was moving very fast compared to the first one we saw when we were using the traditional, very, very old way that is not actually recommended. Okay. Unless otherwise. So you can see, guys, it's very easy, very 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 easy. Okay, you can, I mean, you can use this method to search in case you are planning to create something like an antivirus. I mean, you can just search like this. Okay, do you see it? It's called recursive search. But now I cannot close the program. Why? I'm inside a loop. Yes, I'm inside a loop. So how do I stop the scan? Suppose this is an antivirus, I have to stop the scan. It's very simple. You can see, you see inside this guy here, you can say while this guy equals to like this, and search is equal to true. So search. So I'm gonna create a call, let me call it SR, while SR equals to true. So I'm gonna create a variable here. Yeah, I wanna make it to be global. You can say bool SR. So when the form gets shown here, this thing equals to false. The moment I click start here, which is this button, I make this thing to be equal to true. Okay, so while it's true, okay, let's put a stop button there to stop the scan. So we can put stop there, stop. So on click here, you can say SR equals false and see if it's gonna work. You see, stop, it stopped. You can see it stops, it's no longer scaling. Okay, it stops, as you can see, it stopped. So I can close it now because it was able to stop. But now what if, I'm not sure if it's gonna work, what I want to try now, but what if maybe when you click here it should stop, and while the scan is running, as you can see now, I can run it and start the scan, and then the moment I click here it's not gonna stop until I click stop here. That's when it stops and close. So let's say if you click, you can select the program and go to events, I mean the whole form, and go to events, and then you go on query close. It's somewhere on query close here, on close query, I mean. So you can say if you click the close button, you wanna check if this SR is true. If this SR equals to true, like this, you're gonna make SR to be false, and then you can say can close. So see, it's working. So the moment, regardless if the scan is active or not, I mean, the moment you click here, it's gonna call, it's gonna fire this form query close event, and then you're gonna check if the scan is running. If the scan is running, you stop the scan by saying SR equals to false, and then you're gonna go can close is true, which is this variable. If you make it false, you tell it not to close. So in other ways, you can use also this method to control if the form must be closed or not when the user click here. Okay, yeah, see. So if I can say, if now even if the scan is not running, if I just say can close equal to false like this, can close equal to false like that only, and then I run the program, you can see that. So the moment I'm closing it, it does not close. It's because I said can close, can equal to can close, you know what I mean, it's not closing, right? So you can also use the same method for that in case you don't want the user to close the program for some other reasons that I may not know. So ladies and gentlemen, that's all I wanted to show you. This code is very simple and it's very small. The only thing that might be confusing is this guy here, okay, the one I highlighted. Yes, for my first time it was hectic for me to understand this thing. So but the rest, guys, I hope you really learned something using this method. It's a little bit tricky, but it's also nice once you get used to it. And once again, thanks for watching. And if you liked the video, the 30 minutes video, please and very please subscribe and leave a comment. And of course, you can ask me anything. I can make a tutorial for you if you want. Just ask me, you tell me what you want me to do, and then I'm gonna do it. If I don't know it, I'm gonna research. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, thanks for watching and take care of yourself.